All right, and welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube who's watching this video later on for some more Golgari Stompy. This is, I think, the third time maybe that we've played this here. But this is, I guess, maybe my favorite deck right now. If, you know, like a lot of people ask me, what's your favorite deck kind of thing? And it's hard to answer, but this may be it. I really like this one. I absolutely love Vivian Arcbow Ranger. This is, you know, my favorite card from M20. I've been playing this card a ton because it's just so good. And I like how it works with Rotting Regisaur. The two of those are just such a good combination. You know, Rotting Regisaur is very, very big and can kill people fast, but gets chump blocked easy. And however, if you make it even bigger and give it trample, like Arcbow Ranger's plus one does, it's hard to race the Rotting Regisaur Vivian Arcbow Ranger combo. So definitely really like that. I like the mana creatures here. We get out early. Vivian, Champion of the Wilds, is one of my favorite cards to play, giving all of our creatures flash. It allows us to... it certainly helps against a deck such as Blue-Green Flash that's like trying to counter and play all the things on your turn. Well, if you play all your stuff on their turn, it makes it difficult for them to do that. Or if they try to tap out on your turn to play something, you get to just then resolve your creatures. So yeah, this is a fun deck to play here. I like this quite a bit. We got some pretty nice sideboard cards from M20 with Veil of Summer and Legion's End doing their thing over there. Since the last time we played it, I added in a Vivian and a Carnage Tyrant over here in the sideboard over Harpooners, because Harpooner was a lot bigger. Mono Blue was a lot bigger a little while ago, but we don't really see as much Mono Blue now. And Esper is picking back up in popularity, and so I got this extra Vivian and the Carnage Tyrant because of Esper instead. But yeah, so we're going to be taking this, of course, over to Mythic, seeing how we do play maybe five matches with this deck. And yeah, like if I would play any deck like off stream to just to be a deck to rank up, this would be the deck. This is a deck that I actually played just a little bit off stream whenever we were in Diamond just to get to Mythic. And so we've been having a rough go the last couple of decks we played in Mythic, so hopefully Golgari Stompy gets us back up there. But you never know, it can happen. Let's give it a try. Alright, turn two Rotting Regisaur. Turn three Arcbow Ranger, as long as we draw a land. Looks like I didn't do a reset either after the Tron or after the Ego for resetting Arena. Looks like I should have done a reset here because it's kind of acting up, so I'll have to do that after this match. Hey, Storm. Teamer. Yeah, let's just get this in. Okay, maybe not. Well, I'm kind of glad that Vivian, Champion of the Wilds, was encountered. But I'm sure that card was going to be difficult for them to deal with. What are they doing over here?
Would you like to see what's left of Scum? Starting over is the only way.
Mana creatures with vigilance is always nice. Getting to attack and still cast stuff. Okay, so this is like the blue-green deck. But I guess they're splashing red, probably for removal. Well, so much for the mana creature having vigilance being nice. Definitely wish I did not attack with the Land War Elf now. Go no blocks.
Oh, so it's going to be like that, huh? For the fallen.
Yeah, that was really unfortunate throwing away that Llanowar Elf. Alright, right now I need creatures because I need to be able to play things at instant speed. Vivian's minus two. They're just down to one card left.
There is wonder in a blade of grass.
That's not ideal. That would have been better.
All things begin and end in nature.
Darn.
I'll be back, just like before.
All right. Good job, Choop. Yeah, Lords, you can... it's not like the just the discard version, but the last Grixis Control deck that I played just a couple of days ago, I liked a whole lot. Syncopates have been annoying. Puppy with the save. It's really tough attacking into, like, maybe a Nightpack Ambusher. But yeah, so, you know, if you head on over to the YouTube channel, Lords, you know, look for Grixis Control from the last couple of days. I think probably 2 days, no, maybe 3 days ago now. Not the good time to be drawing lands. Ugh. Big reason why we're going to lose this game, though. Biggest reason is because I attacked with that Llanowar Elf after playing the Vivian. If I don't attack with that Llanowar Elf, we would have been able to minus the Vivian one more time, and you know, wouldn't have had to take the damage there that thing dealt. Oh, why I just should play the land here. Yeah. Oh. All right. Need to play better. All right, Vale of Summers on in here. Carnage Tyrant on in here. Choop's good. What don't I want? Yeah, that's kind of sloppy. Not sure if I want all the duresses too, because that's going to cut my creature count down quite a bit. Kind of feel like Arcbow Ranger may not be where I want to be. All right, here we go. The problem is, yeah, Arcbow would be good in the deck with 28 creatures, but the problem is, to put Arcbows in the deck, you'd just be taking out creatures. Take out the lands. So definitely want the Overgrown Tomb. It's a good chance I'm discarding. I was going to say discarding the Swamp, but we got the Steelleaf Champion. Let's just play that here, where I can still go Rotting Registrar with Vale of Summer next turn. Rotting Registrar, while it's, you know, strong on turn two of as far as, like, winning games, it's also, like, the whole discard thing is kind of rough to have immediately. So we'll be discarding this forest. I want the two black for Chupacabra. Yeah, I guess they didn't have a counter spell for it. Thing's very big. tough call whether to land or the. I definitely want Elf Summer Champion, and so it's tough call whether to land or the. Or the Ripjaw Raptor. Like, if we just draw a whole bunch of lands here, I'm gonna wish that I would have ditched a land, but it's. If we don't find any land, then we're just going to be, like, you know, stuck on mana. If we do draw a bunch of lands, maybe the Vivian still gets us, like, the other creatures and stuff, though. And no, Veil of Summer does not stop that. That's not a counterspell. Okay. One to know. Yeah, Veil of Summer is just awesome. Like, our opponent was in just a whole lot of trouble there. Hey, what's up, Royal Flush? FDE, if you'd like my decks, you can find them all there. Of course, you can find all the decks on the YouTube channel as well. No, I'm not a Hokies fan. Virginia Tech? No. If you want just, like, kind of... a lot of other decks and everything, and check out MTG Goldfish here. Seems like we should be putting back Galta. Yeah, we should be putting back Galta. Leafkin Druid. Have Steel Leaf Champion start bringing the beats. If I would go Rotting Regisaur, we'd have to, you know, discard Land War Elf, which isn't really that big of a deal here, but then the next turn, I don't really know what we're going to be discarding. Steel Leaf Champions are pretty nice because they can't chump block Steel Leaf Champions. Can't block them with the little creatures.
I will protect the virtue of this world. Behold, nature's true power.
Yeah, Feather's a pretty good deck. I haven't played too much Feather myself. I don't really play Best of One, so I can't really say if it's better in Best of One or Best of Three. Well, a very strong start for them.
Forgive me.
Vivian Arcbow Ranger would be our best draw step. That'd be a very good one. Be able to give this Rotting Regisaur Trample. But they're still going to have to start doing some blocking here. Unfortunate.
I've lost so much already. I won't. The mysteries of life are endless.
I need to shuffle this library, get this Galta back. Certainly wish I would have ditched the Ripjaw Raptor and kept the Galta. That would have been a lot better for me. Don't think we're winning this one. We'll see. So going with the Vivian here to look for Ravenous Chupacabra. So I was going for the Vivian, trying to mine us, see if we find Chupacabra.
Wait, you think nature is kind?
Oh yeah, they've risen reefs. I was like, okay, well, just a mana creature, not bad. But I guess it still just draws a card.
Strike now! Strike hard!
A little late for Vivian. Yeah, discard that Nissa. No, the best deck in the metagame is definitely not Scapeshift.
I've survived an apocalypse. I will survive you. You fight like a city brat. My, my, how you've grown.
I only have one Growth Chamber Guardian left.
Tear it down. Tear it all down. That's one more arrow knocked.
All right, let's clear this up. Still got the Vivian Reed. Down to their five lands now. I should not have played that temple yet. That was bad. Definitely should be ticking up on the Vivian first and then playing temple.
Meet my newest friend. I've seen puppies whine less than you.
Looks like this game's
I've
over.
I've seen things that would break someone like you. Have you ever lost a home?
That game didn't look so good for us for a little while there. Yeah, Vivian Tribal. Pretty D's. Cool. Yeah, this is basically Vivian Tribal. We got all the Vivians in here. All right, so I want the other two, but want the Masquer Girl, want the Veil of Summers, kind of want the Legion's Ends, honestly, because since they're like, they're certainly very Hydra-based if they're playing the Gargos. So the other two Hydras are both two power. So Legion's End Exiles, you know, Krasis and the other one. Voracious. I'm going to get rid of these Growth Chamber Guardians. You're a Thorn Lieutenant also? I don't want to just get rid of all of those. Though, wait, how many? It's 26 creatures. If I cut three more, it goes down to 23. Ugh, that's not that many. Let's cut one Champion of the Wilds. And then two of these other ones. Maybe a Ripjaw? No, Ripjaw's cool. Maybe just the Steel Leaves? No? I really don't want to be playing all these Veil of Summers, but we saw them with Entrancing Melody. and they're likely going to have, mass manipulation, post board, and all that kind of stuff. And we just played two, but I don't want to get my stuff stolen, but I also don't really want to have Veil of Summer in my deck, so it's kind of hit or miss here. Yes, you can target a forest creature with Legion's End. If Nissa ticks up on like three forests, you can exile all the forests and any forest they have in hand with Legion's End. I wish I had a mana creature. Wasting my time in the waiting line. What's up? I would like another land, but I don't really want I don't really want two lands. So like keeping one land now means that like the next land we would draw would be like not so good. So. Good, we got rid of it. Hey, powerhouse. I don't want to discard like any of these cards. I don't want to play Rotting Regisaur yet. I wanted to be playing Vivian, Champion of the Wilds, so I could flash in like these creatures, but honestly, if I play Vivian and they have like Nissa, that's pretty rough. So I'm just going to go with Steel Leaf. Yeah, with the new mulligan rule, mulliganing is really not so bad. It's something that we should be doing more of.
Rise, my elemental friend.
Six loyalty. Why can't it just be five? Why can't it be five? Nissa has to be six. Bleh.
I am Scarlet's Vengeance, and I'm coming for you next. This will be fun to watch.
If Nissa was just five, we'd be able to play the Arcbow, kill their blocker, and then kill Nissa.
Of the ground you walk on. I've endured worse.
If I would have just played the Rotting Registrar first, we would have been able to kill Danessa, but...
We're fit enough.
They may have
survive.
Just Entrancing Melody'd the Rotting Registrar, though. We don't know if they had that card or not. All right. We're going to bring in... We're going to play all these... Veil of Summers. I guess Duress also. Like, why... Why are Entrancing Melody and Mass Manipulation? Like, why are these cards? Come on. Like, the only tenant's not really actually beating anybody, right? All right, we got a nice strong hand here. Let's see if we get to stomp. Hopefully no land Werewolf over there. Put a land into play tapped. Darn it. Wow, that was not good. Not good for us. If they had a little bit of a slow hand, we were going to be crushing them here, but they, it looks like they did not. Did not at all. Yeah, Entrancing Melody and Mass Manipulation are, they're the two best mind control effects that I can remember being in Standard. And they're both in the same Standard with ridiculous ramp creatures also. But yeah, I can't remember other ones being so good. Well, good news is I think they're dead. Right? So like they have to take this 6.
I love everything from deer to dinosaurs.
Puts them down to 5. And then yeah, 8 trample. Yep, they're dead.
We're fit enough to survive.
That was a good match. Turn 4 kill. And so that's what I'm talking about of Rotting Regisaur with Vivian Arcbow Ranger giving it trample. It's just, it's a lot of damage.
It's a lot of damage.
All right, 2-0. Getting our rank back up there. Oh yeah, Land of War Elf. The difference between hands when you have Land of War Elf and when you don't have Land of War Elf are just so vast. Land of War Elf is certainly a card that also, like, with London Mulligan rule, like, you're just going to have Land of War Elf a lot more too. So it's a card that really increased in value, if you know, if it even needed increasing in value. This Land of War Elf in there. 3 is not very much life. Hey, what's up, Brad? So they have to deal with the Steel Leaf and block the Ripjaw Raptor, and then one of either Thorn Lieutenant or Land of War Elf. I don't know how they're doing all that. I mean, if they have Omnath here, Omnath could kill Land War Elf, and then they could jump some creatures. But obviously, that wouldn't be good enough for us having Arcbow and Chupacabra still. All right, so this time we don't have to play the Veil of Summers, which is nice. So we can just cut the Growth Chamber Guardians and play this. Call it a day. Ooh, yeah, Cavalier of Night with these big 3-mana creatures. It's hard to get triple black and Steel Leaf Champion in triple black. Difficult. Hey, what's up, Balding Yeti? Oh yeah, this deck is pretty good. Now I've had last two hands, I've had a really good. You know, I've had turn one Land War Elf hands the last two games. So we need to draw untapped black. Give ourselves another turn. See if we can draw untap black. Or Steel Leaf Champion. So I have two options here. I could kind of not do anything and try to Masker Girl next turn. That would require them playing a creature with toughness 2 or less. That may not be very realistic. Let's just go Rotting Regisaur. Ah, they did. All right, so if I Masker Girl, are all the... So let's see. They get -1, and then -2, -3, -4, -5. So if there's no more creature... Darn. All right, so Rotting Regisaur will die to Masker Girl now.
Nature will take back what rightfully belongs to it. This'll be fun to watch.
Certainly want Vivian to stay around.
I'd get out of the way if I were you.
So like if I minus three the Vivian and try to fight these and then they have like a something to kill to get rid of the Registrar Alpha, that's not good for us. I'll play it a little safer, go this route.
We're fit enough to survive.
This means obviously that we don't have lethal, but I mean, come on. We're doing just fine. Yeah, not that might make them fight. I mean, just if they had like a bounce spell, not make them fight, but just do the damage. I brought in the Ravenous Chupacabra, so I didn't have another one in my sideboard. Otherwise, yeah, I would have minus five for Chupacabra if I had another one in my sideboard, but I didn't. Best thing I could have grabbed from my sideboard was Carnage Tyrant, but I just had five mana, so that wouldn't have really worked. But yeah, all the Chups were in the deck. No, it's okay. Good question there. We can do better than that. I'm going risky here. I'm getting rid of the swamp because the swamp doesn't cast Steel Leaf Champion, or I mean, it kind of casts. I guess it casts the Arbor Ranger, but it doesn't cast the Steel Leaf Champion. And we're going to need like another land anyway, so I'm just going to get rid of that swamp. All right, well, we may pay for it. I went with that route because we had the Scry land. Ah, always had it. Field of the Dead deck. Field of the Dead creatures cannot block Steel Leaf Champion. Neither can that. Nice, Starman. Yeah, glad you're enjoying the Gruul midrange deck. Yeah. Arcbow Ranger is just awesome. Definitely love me some Arcbow Ranger. Yeah, those jokes on them. Those 42 zombies they get can't block the Steel Leaf Champion. Dedicated tutor target for Vivian. Besides Ceratops, Carnage Tyrant is a very good one. You're going green-red. You have Daredevil in red. You could have a Chain Whirler in your sideboard if you think you can get to triple red. It'd be like a late game kind of thing. Are they dead? No, they go to one. Go to two. Ravager Worm. That's a really good one for green-red. Ravager Worm coming in, fighting something. Voracious Hydra also is a good one.
I love everything from deer to dinosaurs. Stomping time.
All right, they're down to one. They can get a bunch of zombies, but they can't block Steel Leaf Champion. And they're at one life. So what you got? They got nothing. So Legion's End takes out all the zombies. They're probably going to have Noxious Grasp. Like, that's going to be their main thing. Give this a try. This Champion of the Wilds may just be slow. Am I supposed to be playing Veil of Summers? Probably not. We would have to have a one toughness creature for Masker Girl to kill the Escape Shift tokens. There'd have to also be a one toughness creature. It may be better just to have it over here that maybe Arcbow Ranger can grab. I don't think they're playing Mana Dorks or Risen Reefs. This is not that deck. Wrong Vivian. So close to being a perfect hand. So I think I'm going to lead with the Overgrown Tomb, so I discard the forest later. No, we'll discard the temple. That's a great card.
Wild animals I like. People, you can still walk away.
Where's Vivian? We need 4 CMC Vivian. So they had turn 3 circuitous route. Crasis. Really hope they don't find Scapeshift. No, actually never did end up seeing the Queen movie.
Let me show you what was lost.
That's respect. For dying out of nowhere right there. Cool, it's fantastic. Good to hear. Yeah, it was one that I like wanted to see, just never ended up seeing it. It's kind of hard for me to see movies with streaming every day like I do. Oh no, Blast Zone. My plan was to just drop down the Steel Leaf champion, but not with them having Blast Zone that they're certainly going to want to be putting on 3. So I guess I'm just going Growth Chamber Guardian activate.
There is wonder in a blade of grass.
All right, so they'll blow up my Vivian and my Regisaur. Obviously, I don't want to flash in the champion in response.
I've seen worse.
No, that was not a good card for us to see. Don't draw that thing. pressing our hand, not letting us play the champion. I'll keep this. I can find some more 7/6s. Crab people. Crab people. So that's our... We've gotten 3 crab people out so far. There's one more. Yeah, Sorin is such a good card with that vampire deck. Sorin raised the power level of that vampire deck so much on its own. Stop drawing these things. Jeez.
How this thing goes is up to you, pal. Strike now! Strike hard!
Crises. Got a major crisis right now. I guess maybe I'm supposed to keep Chupacabra in the deck. I cut Chupacabra, but so I was thinking about the 8/8 flyers we're going to be dealing with. All right, so we need to draw Legion's End here. We got 2 Legion's Ends in the deck. I guess maybe I should just have Massacre Girl in here. Maybe I should. I don't know. I like our chances game 3 on the play. We didn't have a very fast hand here. And we were looking pretty good. With them having no cards in hand. Whenever, like after our duress, but they drew Crisis, which drew another Crisis, which drew another Crisis. Field of the Dead is testament to why you should always compost. So it's just 20 lands, they still have a good amount more lands. So I could grab the other Growth Chamber Guardian from my deck to thin it, but then that's also shuffles 2 dead cards, so it's actually goes down a card. Really? You were the top card? But yeah, this Vivian did not seem like she mattered too much. in this matchup. Galt to get back over here. I don't know if I really want to play Masker Girl, because it's like whenever we get to that point of the game, it's already pretty rough for us. Because all they have to do is just keep playing more lands. We just cut one of these Vivians for a Chupacabra. To have a Chupacabra in here. Let's just do that. Oh, new Vivian is just amazing. Yeah, the card is awesome. That's definitely... If one of our... We had like two of the three mana Vivians. If either of those was the four mana Vivian, we would have won that game. With the trample. Ugh. Could be a really cool hand. Don't have the lands, though. Big Vivian here in this matchup, I think, is probably too slow. I think she's probably too slow in this matchup. We want to draw new Vivian. So we want to draw. Are they playing Growth Spiral? Well, you realize this costs black mana. I don't have black mana. I can't jam this. Now I can. Now I have Paradise Druid. Hey, Zealous. Aethergust. No rejuvenators. Ugh. This game played out so well for them. If we only had Big Vivian, either of these, either last game or this game. Not Big Vivian, but you know, Vivian Arcbow Ranger, 4 mana Vivian. Give this Rotting Register trample. And make it a lot bigger. Come on, four mana Vivian. They got it. Man, who would have thought we would have got wrecked by Aether Gust? Who would have thought wrecked by Aether Gust on that Paradise Druid? I guess I should put the Paradise Druid back on top. I thought it was going to be kind of too slow to wait and, you know, draw the Paradise Druid, replay it, and then so on. But I think we would have been better off if I would have put it on top, you know, looking back at it, looking at our draws. But we can't make that decision first. Darn. This may be the first time that I've ever lost to this Scapeshift deck with any deck ever. I don't think I've ever lost to this deck before. Not that I can remember. Oh well, 3-1. All right, one more match here, and then we'll move on to Rakdos Midrange. We're playing 5 matches here in ranked with our deck. Let's bring it back and have a better start than that. Okay. No, the second temple. Love. Glad I put the other land back. It's not like spectacular, but it's probably better than a random draw. No, I haven't built a Rakdos Demon deck. No. Yeah, this deck's good.
I have not survived millennia to stand down now. Our fiends thirst for life.
Soren's so good.
You cannot hurt my hollow soul.
Civilization has crept too far. Tear it down. We're gonna tear you apart.
Let's see, we're going to six. Alright, wouldn't mind drawing a land here so we get to play both of our cards. I definitely want to be playing the Champion of the Wilds. Alright, we get to play Land Werewolf. So I want to give the Steel Leaf Champion Vigilance so we can start putting a clock on him.
For the Fallen.
Yeah, well, I'm not sure if Feather, you know, after Reckless Rage, is it still going to be playable? I'm not sure. We'll have to see, you know, what it gains and everything. How it's gone the last couple of sets, they sure are printing a lot of cards for Feather. So I would like its chances to be able to stick around. It's the kind of deck that's also a little bit slower, and so it's that's the kind of deck that will certainly gain... gain playability with Land War Elf rotating out of the format. That certainly helps that deck. Hey, D-Lev. Welcome back. Thanks for the sub there. It's our fourth sub of the day. Almost halfway to our first sub goal today. Been a little slow on the sub, so thank you so much, D-Lev. Thanks for kicking us into gear there. You are awesome.
Worst possible card for us to see.
My bloodline flows through you.
Tear it down. Tear it all down.
Darkness will always return.
Just certainly hope they don't draw any more Sorens. The Lord would not be a very good card to see either. The thing that gives all their all these vampires +1/+1. I didn't have the mana last turn to play Growth Chamber Guardian. Oh, if you're talking about let's see. So you block here. They're going to gain 5 life, go to 17. Okay, they're not paying 4 with either Vanguard. It's good news for us. This is all bad news, though. That was all bad news.
You fight like a city brat.
Yeah, Champion of Dusk, good card. Well, my Paradise Druid was summoning sick. I just played it, so I could not tap the Paradise Druid for mana.
That should be game. I don't have, you know, Massacre Girls in the sideboard. Ask a girl, get on in here. Yeah, you could definitely play more Massacre Girls in this deck. I just have one in here, but yeah, that's certainly an option to have more in the deck than just one. Growth Chamber Guardian is basically just not good against anything except for Esper. Just gets outclassed. All right, we're going to have to win games 2 and 3. I just don't really know what to play instead of Growth Chamber Guardian. Like, I'm not sold on Knight of the Ebon Legion for this deck. Or, like, I don't know, more Thorn Lieutenants. I don't know, there's basically no option that I like. Which is why I'm still playing Growth Chamber Guardian, because I don't really like anything else. For, like, you know, 1 and 2 mana. Okay.
Defeating you will not bring me pleasure. Join my welcome to the family.
Temple of Malady cost me this game. We just had Ripjaw Raptor in play. If we just had Ripjaw Raptor in play, we'd be able to, like, play the Arcbow, kill the champion, kill their Sorin. We'd be doing just fine.
I've survived an apocalypse. I will survive you. Get him.
Good hand on the opponent's side, though. You know, you have to say good job to the opponent. You know, when they have one drop, removal for your 5/4, and then Sorin that puts in Champion of Dusk, and then Legion's Lieutenant plus Knight of the Ebon Legion.
I've seen too many species die already.
Just gotta say good job. Not much else to do. Card's just so incredibly good. It's very, very good. A 6/7 death touch is not a bad one drop either, though. Darn. All right, so we started off really well. Was defeated the last two. But no shame in going 3-2 over there on Mythic. No shame in that at all. The main thing is, I basically like everything in the deck except for... I don't really like the Growth Chamber Guardians or the Thorn Lieutenants. But we have to just be, you know, we can't just not have the two drops, you know, like having like the two drops does make Arcbow Ranger better and everything. So it's, I'm going to have to maybe like go back to the drawing board and kind of look through all of the two mana cards, you know, one and two mana cards and see what to be doing there. I used to have like Pelt Collector instead of Thorn Lieutenant. I don't really love Pelt Collector either. It's, Pelt Collector is fine, though. Maybe that's what I'm supposed to be going back is more Pelt Collector. I don't think I want more mana creatures. I think that these are very good. The other mana creatures are like the zero power ones, and I don't think this deck really wants those. So I'll have to maybe kind of go back to the drawing board, see what we can do. Because Growth Chamber Guardian is just not... it's not impressive. Explore package just takes up too many slots. Like I don't want to be playing Jade Light Ranger. Maybe Branchwalker just on its own. Maybe just Branchwalker, Kral Harpooner. You know, Kral Harpooner giving us that stuff just main deck against flyers. But anyway, no, Arboreal not playable. No, but anyway, the deck's very good still. You know, like it's a very good deck, as we saw with those games and everything. It's definitely a very good deck, and like I said, probably my favorite deck to play right now. I think, you know, it's close. It's not perfect. So we talked about, like, with the two drops, it's not perfect. Good chance that maybe I just need another Masker Girl over here. Maybe Barkhide Troll. I feel like that probably gets outclassed by everything too, but I don't know. Maybe the troll. Maybe. But all right, that's Golgari Stompy though. So if you're watching this video later on YouTube, hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. But thank you so much for watching here, and I will see you for the next video.